Happy day. Happy day. Oh my goodness. Hello. Welcome. Welcome to this moment. I am doing wonderfully. Just taking a little break from work tasks. Fun work tasks. It's like designing stuff. And you? Welcome. Yeah, it's fun. Relaxing. This is a great place to relax. Oh, yeah. I'm always curious of what comes up during this time. And thank you for stopping by to say hi. I appreciate it. Yeah, almost a year. Almost a year. But I hope you are well. We're just gonna take this moment to invite some deep breaths and some awareness into our bodies right now, our vessels. Lots of deep breaths, just reminding yourself how powerful you are. How loved you are. Good. Always pushing through. That's the good thing, is to always just keep pushing. Keep pausing and taking moments with yourself and for yourself so you can just like ground it all. Okay, bye. Thank you for stopping by and have a beautiful day. Wonderful. Yes, yes. So taking this moment to yourself and having a breath, a pause within your day. You deserve it. You deserve it. So I was like, how long will I last in that position? Okay, got it. Not long. Yeah. Maybe like this. How are you feeling today? It's Thursday. You might still be on these week things, tracking things by the week and the days and stuff. So what is happening in this time, in this moment? How are you feeling? Did you have goals at the beginning of the week? Did you have goals at the beginning of the week that you put forth that you said you wanted by the end of this week, which is tomorrow, right? You don't work Saturday and Sunday, right? So what are you doing between now and tomorrow to be closer to those goals that you put forth? It's a great check-in time. What's left for the week? Take a moment and ponder that. Know that when you walk away from this moment, you have nothing, no weight on you, nothing pulling at you, nothing telling you that you have to be anywhere except for what your heart desires, what your authority desires. Your authority within, sacral, ego, emotional, splenic, mental, self. What is your human design authority, your energetic authority within, and how can you listen to that today? How can you listen to that so that it guides you into your next version, your next portion of your day within the energy that you are going to harness right here? A really, really great way to do this is to ask yourself a question and see how you respond to it. Without any filtering, see how you respond. Ask yourself, what do I want to do after lunch today? And then listen. Whatever that initial response is, that's what you desire. Now, whether or not you can have it, achieve it, do it, that's up to you. But there's your answer. And don't try to change it. Your body knows. Your body knows. Your brain doesn't need to be activated in this at all. Just allow your body to let you know what's next. So what are you going to do? Closer to your goals, listening to your inner authority to complete your goals tomorrow. What are you going to do after lunch? Think about that. You're so close. You are so close to achieving the next thing, and the next thing, and the next, and the next, and the next. And soon, you're going to be behind all of these things that you've just completed and that you're done with, and you're going to say, that's exactly what I needed to do, and I did it, and it took this step, and 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 all these steps. But I'm here. I did it. I am here. Oh my goodness. Oh. I'm so glad that I did not give up. I wonder if there's something within your life where you felt that energy. Where you felt, oh, it's just been so hard, oh, I don't want to do the rest. There's so much left. I don't want to complete this. I can't do it. I'm not enough. I can't finish this. Time rolls on. You end up showing up for whatever you end up showing up for within your day. And soon you turn around and you look at how you've handled it. How you've indeed got yourself up, got yourself through, and are pushing on through life as if that was nothing but a blip. And it was. But during the time, it was just so monumental. Ah, what a wonderful release to know that in the moment, what you feel, your emotions, how you feel in a moment, are fleeting. They will be gone tomorrow. I mean, maybe you'll feel the same tomorrow, but definitely at a less magnified way. And so that's why I encourage you, when you are in a super emotional state, especially if you are emotional authority in human design, just take the time to sit still. Just be still and listen to yourself. Hear what your body has to say. Hear what your authority has to say. Hear the messages, rather than just plowing through life and never stopping to commend, to gander, to peek on, all of these different things, all these different things that you can do for yourself, with yourself, to check in, because who's checking in on you? Nobody. Also, side note, who's checking in on your people? If you're not being checked in on, who do you think's checking in on your people? Could it be that you are the check-inner? Are you the person that calls everyone? Maybe initiate some calls. 12-12. Maybe get some calls going. Check in on your people. Yes. Authority. Just pausing. It's just so important. Just pause. We go over so many different reasons of why meditation is so powerful and so important in our lives. And it just keeps delivering. Just something wonderful that is present is that our thoughts are always leaving. They're coming and they're going, and they're coming and they're going, and they're coming and they're going. And if you can ever catch yourself in a moment of picking up on one of those thoughts and like holding on to it and riding the ride while it all goes all wild, if you find yourself doing that, just let go. Just let go, be still. Maybe chuckle at the ride I imagine like this balloon that's being deflated. It's like, shh. But honestly, I was imagining like this horse that's like bucking through, and then he has a lasso, and you're like, ooh, this thought looks fun. And then you grab it. Now you're being all whipped around. Let go. Let it go. Look how comfortable your life is now. Look how relieved you are from that stress that came from just a thought. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. It's a blessing. Once you are able to master this, once you are able to step into the observer view of your life, you will be the master of your life. It's going to be so powerful. You're going to be able to witness yourself doing things, reacting in shadow ways, reacting in ways that are not within your authority. And you're going to be like, self, stop it. Self, you know that's not what we do anymore. You know that. And then self is going to be like, hee-hee. This is what was comfortable. Like, this is how we used to do it all the time. And I didn't know you were aware and awake and watching me. But I see you're watching me now. So I'll do the new thing that you've been trying to program me to do. I got it. Oh, my gosh. It's just so true. When you have a relationship with yourself, it becomes this kind of siblinghood of these different these different versions of you within yourself being like, no, we're doing this. Well, I want to do this right now. Well, that's not within our higher self, so we're not doing that anymore. And it's like, oh, well, look who has a backbone now. And it's like, I win. I see my highest vision. I see my highest self, and I will commit to that daily. I don't take a break on that. I don't say, I'm taking a break from my highest purpose today. I don't do that, and neither do you, not intentionally anyway, but when you are reaching for things that are in the complete opposite direction of your highest self, of your life, what you intend to embody and accomplish in this world, and then you're watching yourself do it too, why? Really? So this is a moment. Maybe like rewind what everything I just said. This is a moment to take a piece of paper and answer that question. Answer that question. Because what is keeping you from your highest life? Why is it that you're not there yet? Really ponder that. Think about it. How are you sabotaging yourself? I just added like three more questions, but that question I said was a really great one to write down. Let's breathe. So today I was gonna come on here and talk about twin flames because it's come up again. I think there's like a show about it now or something. Like it's a potential client. It's someone who reached out and asked me about it and speaking with her, and I'm just like, yeah, it's exciting, but oh my goodness. Power to you all on these twin flame journeys, like truly. So yeah, we'll talk about that when we're done with meditation, because it really does just take some pondering, doesn't it? Twin flames, wow. I'm thinking of ways to deliver it without bias is the thing. I've been through it. You can hear the emotion in my voice about it. Yeah, man, the twin flames, it's a trip. You gotta hold on tight for that one, okay? It's beautiful and wonderful, but you gotta hold on tight. She asked me, how can I ground myself through these emotions that I'm feeling? I just feel so much about it. And I'm like, that is a great question. Powerful question. And I gave it all to her. Community, stay around your girlfriends, stay within yourself, love yourself, remember how powerful you are. I mean, gosh, affirmations to stay aware, stay within self when you are on a love journey in general, not just a twin flame journey, but if you are on a twin flame journey and you're not doing those things to ground yourself, first of all, reach out. Second of all, please, like, find resources. Please. Do not get sucked into the tunnel of the twin flame. It's beautiful, but it is a flame, and you are the moth, okay? You are the moth, and that flame is so sexy, so beautiful, so bright, so everything you can ever see and love, and it even reminds you of you a little bit in the way, you know, that the flame, it flickers just like your wings and you want to go to it. It's just so beautiful. It's kind of like you, and you want to fix it because you know exactly how you can fix it, but then you also want to just love on it. You want to just get all up in it and hug it, even though you know that thing is fire, is straight up fire. And then you fly into it. Bless you all in your twin flame journeys. Bless you all. The greatest of life lessons encompassed in love. back to the breath, deep breaths. Inhale love into your body. Inhale what you need into your body. Deep breaths. Invite your deep breaths into your vessel. I'm lusting after that sun out there. After these meditations, I go for a walk. It's glorious. How was the pause? How do you feel? Did any messages come up that you may want to write down? This focus on yourself is very powerful, isn't it? Just life-changing. Do this forever. Keep looking at yourself. Keep asking yourself questions. Keep checking in. Do this forever. It's the way. It's our maintenance. The soul. It becomes natural. The maintenance. An honor to show up for. And a non-negotiable daily practice of self-love. There's nothing nothing better than it. Nothing that is better than it. That is more important. Nothing. Nothing. Okay, now let's speak a little bit on this twin flame situation, which I already have a little bit. Enjoy that. I say, you know, I don't want to share from a biased perspective, but here's the thing. I can share from my perspective. I can share from my perspective of the twin flame situation, and you are going to use discernment and, you know, decipher what resonates with you and what does not, okay? Always and everything, always, always, always. Nothing I say, nothing anyone says, any readers, any person with a platform, nothing anyone says is telling you to do anything. You must always look within and decide within your authorities within whether something is for you or down the route that you want to be. Plain and simple, okay? My experience with the twin flame, deepest, deepest of loves, like deepest, deepest loves. I still feel it. It's still here today. I still feel him. I was reading my journal today and it was like, just like deep, deep. Like I feel you all the time, all the time. He's literally a piece of me, a part of me. And during my relationship with this person, I even create a dialogue around this. You are my everything, you're my other half, you're my energy, my generator, like that kind of, like, you know, if you ever do leave, I'm going to be in some kind of lack. And so when you create that rhetoric, when you create that vibration within what you're saying and what is actualizing, you create a life where indeed you feel a loss when you lose that person, when really they are put into your life to teach you those lessons and float away. Twin flames are not always meant to stay together. They're not meant to be together. They're meant to bring out the darkness within each other, honestly. The darkness and the extreme light intertwined together before it explodes, honestly. And it doesn't always explode. Some twin flames do get to be together, and that's because they've been able to do their self-healing before they entered a relationship, or they're able to communicate and have all of these different ways of actually working for the relationship rather than creating something that they hope or intend for. But in a huge way, I mean, we are very just mental health prone society. So a lot of people with mental health issues are creating partnerships together. They are twin flames, but they have this human construct going on of trauma. And it's like, there's this love, there's this deep love that wants to happen, but all of these human reactions and psychological things get in the way. They just get in the way, and you don't get to win as a union until that stuff is handled, plain and simple. And so if you are presented with someone who is a twin flame energy and you're not ready within, run. Run away. I mean, unless you're ready for the extreme tower moments that are to happen. Like the extreme, I'm talking like they will bring out the sides of you within that you hide away. If you think that you've done ego training, these energies will bring up the things that piss you off, that make you so angry. They're the reflection of everything that just, like maybe like an old version of you, that they're going to reflect it. How are you going to react to it? So, wow. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I am just putting forth all of the light, all of the power to you. Just know that in extreme light, there's also extreme darkness. And if you guys can team up to take on all that darkness, it's going to be just so beautiful and wonderful. And you can do it. Just hold grace for each other, love each other, protect each other along the way, and you'll be fine. But if you're still on that journey on your own, I mean, keep the focus up. And like I was telling one of my potential clients, she's not a client yet, but I was telling her, you know, stay around community, stay around girlfriends, go out, meet people. Don't just be inside sucking in all of this love energy, all of this love. Oh my goodness, we saw each other. It was so beautiful. I want to do this, but like, you will literally lose yourself. You will lose yourself in this twin flame energy that's pulling you, saying, come to me. Lose your life in this fucking love. No, please, please don't. This is a cautionary tale, okay? You can take my advice, or you can, you know, you can leave it. Just as I said, like, use your own discernment, okay? It's quite the game. Remember that this is your life. Years of your life. Years of your life. Be wise. Feel into, I'm telling you right now, if you have butterflies around your person, assess those butterflies, because it's that exact energy that I'm talking about that mirrors the very thing that makes you anxious and like, oh my gosh, what is this? Like, you should be able to feel calm in front of your love, your twin flame. Yes, if you feel calm within, then possibly there's a calmness within him or them as well, right? Oh my goodness. Wow, I guess I could talk about this for a super long time, but thank you so much for joining me today, meditating and self-love, and don't forget to love yourself and protect yourself from that twin flame energy. But also bask in it once you really, really get it, because it's beautiful and wonderful. You've got it.